And there's the folks who answered the distress call. Cerberus Cruiser. At least a dozen fighters on blockade duty. Not too many for us in a straight-up fight. They must want this place bad.
Receiving incoming transmission.
Let's hear it.
SSV Normandy, this is Kaylee Sanders, director of Grissom Academy. We need immediate assistance. Cerberus is attacking the facility. They're after my students.
This is Commander Shepard. We're blocked on a direct approach.
I know. They've taken control of our docking base.
Any alternatives?
There's an auxiliary cargo port I could probably open.
All right. We'll come in by shuttle and get your students out of there. Joker, can you give me a diversion?
Oh boy, can I? Come and get me!
Keep the shuttle in position. We'll be back. Sanders, we're clear. It's me.
Commander, thank you. Admiral Anderson always said you were the best. And with Cerberus coming for my students, I need the best.
How many of you are there?
Fewer than 20. Most were sent home when word of the Reaper invasion spread. But a few volunteered to stay. Some are prototyping tech for the Alliance. Others are biotics. They've been training for military operations. Working together as biotic artillery.
You said something about Admiral Anderson.
Yes. We met... God, what's it been? 20 years ago when he was a Spectre candidate. I was there when Saren betrayed him. David saved my life that day. He's a good man.
He was on Earth when the Reapers hit. He stayed behind when I got off-world.
I hadn't heard. We've been cut off from most news. He's alive?
Alive and fighting. He's currently leading the Resistance movement.
Good. If we get out of here, well, just tell him to stay alive.
A few months knocking over practice dummies can't prepare your students for war.
Agreed, but the Alliance needs every resource it can get. And our students are unique resources. They wanted to help. How could we say no with the entire galaxy falling apart? Hang on, I've been trying to get communications working.
This is Froberg. There are students trapped in Orion Hall. Cerberus has us boxed in. They're closing fast.
Damn it.
Orion Hall?
Back out the door and down the hallway. I can get the door open.
I'll bring him back here and we'll make a run for the shuttle.
Thank you, Commander. I'll stay put. With luck, I can regain control of some of our systems.
I'll get the door for you. It leads to Orion Hall.
Files have been neutral alive. But your sister, she's optional. You give us trouble, we'll find her.
There may be more nearby. Play dead until it's safe, then get to Kaylee Sanders in security.
Okay, but my sister Sean is out here somewhere too. Damn it. Slap some Metagel on there before she bleeds out.
Sean, can you hear me?
How do you know my name?
I saved your brother. He's with Kaylee Sanders at security. Can you get to her?
Yeah. I just need to rest for a minute. Thank you.
Jack!
Shepard? Everyone get down! This thing's out of your league! Shepard, keep it off us!
The students aren't a trained military force. They need support.
SOS. I had no idea the King of the Boy Scouts would show up. All right, amp check. Prangley, those fields were weak. Cerberus isn't gonna lie down out of pity like that girl you took to prom. Grab juice and an energy bar. We move in five. Damn it! How many times did I tell you not to trust Cerberus?
You're not telling me anything I haven't told myself, Jack.
Oh, you feel bad? Well, shit. I bet that's a big comfort to all the people Cerberus has killed.
Jack's personality appears largely unchanged.
Hey, Edie. Nice body. Now you look like a sex bot instead of a sex toy.
Okay. Right now, all I care about is getting my guys out of here.
Your guys?
Yeah. I guess so.
I can't think of anybody who could care about them more.
Well, I had some free time while you were off playing hero. Alliance Brass knew I helped you. They offered me this. And apparently the students responded well to my teaching style.
The psychotic biotic!
I will destroy you! Drink your juice, Rodriguez. You couldn't destroy wet tissue paper.
Cortez to extraction team. The Cerberus cruiser is coming back.
How long have we got?
2 minutes tops, Commander. After that, there's no way we'll get past them.
Get out of here and back to the Normandy. We'll find another way off the station.
Roger that. Good luck, sir.
Shepard to Sanders. The students are safe, but the shuttle's a no-go.
Understood. I might know another way off the station, but I need station-wide camera access. Can you disable the Cerberus security override? It's routed through Orion Hall, so it should be nearby.
How does camera access get us off this station?
We need to reach the Cerberus shuttles. The cruiser won't auto-target friendly ships, which gives us a fighting chance to escape. Get me back the cameras, and I'll find a path to the shuttles that keep Cerberus from boxing you in.
Sanders, you should have access now.
Got it. The fastest way is through the atrium, but Cerberus has sealed the doors. You'll need to disable the magnetic locks. The overrides should be directly above the door.
Hey, let me know when we've got a new way off this station.
How are the students handling the war?
How do you think? They're a bunch of teenagers. Until a few months ago, their biggest concern was getting laid.
You don't think they're ready for war?
I don't think they have a choice.
So, all this talk about biotic artillery strikes.
It's great in theory. Maybe they'll get it together once they've seen some action.
But?
They'd be better off as support. Put them in the back ranks, helping with barriers and shit. I don't know.
Have you told them that?
No. They need me to believe in them. I did pick up a few things listening to your damn speeches.
I have to say, Jack, you look good.
Yeah, well, maybe some of your attitude rubbed off on me. I never had a family. And these guys... Anyone screws with my students, I will tear them apart.
What's so valuable about these students? Biotically, I mean.
Well, what's scarier than a pissed-off biotic attacker? A whole bunch of them working together. It's like a biotic artillery strike. Any asshole gets in our way, we rip him to shreds.
Isn't that the kind of thing you wanted to destroy on Pragya?
You know damn well it wasn't. Cerberus was torturing kids on Pragya. These guys are older, and they volunteered, and the only ones feeling any pain are the bad guys.
Stay close. We'll get you out of here.
Good.
You really think we're getting out of here?
Of course we are. Don't talk like that.
Sorry. So, our teacher worked with Commander Shepard? That's pretty badass.
Yeah. Wonder why she never mentioned it.
I can't believe you and our teacher work together.
How's
with both
head?
Of you here.
Hot. I think
maybe
I
we've got a chance.
Just drink your juice. You'll be fine.
We'll be ready when you need us, Commander.
You hear Cerberus saying people's names? They must have files on all of us.
What? Who'd make a file on you? Your biotic can barely lift 100 kilos.
Yeah, but at least I passed biomathematics.
Got it.
You should be able to force the door open now. I'll get to the shuttles ahead of you and get a pair ready to fly.
I'm going to the beach.
Which beach?
Ilium. Hotel Azure has a resort beach with waves and everything. Nothing but lonely as starry girls as far as you can see.
That's assuming the Reapers haven't hit Ilium yet.
You keep thinking like that, you'll die on the station. You've got to find something to focus on.
Everyone be ready. We'll go in first and draw their fire.
We'll shadow you from the second level and hit those guys from above.
I like it. Keeps them safer, too.
Just time your shots and stay safe.
All right. I didn't bust my ass training you so you could die now. Keep low, pick your targets.
Students of Grissom Academy, the station is sealed. The Alliance soldiers cannot save you. All they can do is get you killed. Surrender peacefully and you won't be harmed.
Asshole.
Damn it, they're messaging everyone. Students, switch your Omni tools to privacy mode so they can't track you.
What if they're not lying?
You've already held your own against Cerberus. You've been trained for this by one of the best.
Come on, Rodriguez. They're only asking nicely because you scared them in that last fight. So take your balls out of your purse and kick some ass.
Yes, ma'am.
Let's go.
Thank you.
for action?
Hell yeah!
Get ready! More on the way!
We're in the atrium.
I'm taking a back route to the shuttles. I'll meet you there.
Nice one, Prangley!
Secure the target.
You come after my kids, you are dead here!
Okay up there?
Rodriguez took one in the arm because she didn't watch her barrier.
Commander, I've reached the Cerberus shuttles without being detected. They know what they're doing, though. You need to hurry.
That's an impressive barrier, Octavia. Our file says you've been working on shield technology.
It's a handheld, a multi-core solution based on cyclonic barrier technology, and it's pronounced Octavia.
Why don't you come out peacefully?
Why don't you fight me?
Your cousin Joanna is already on the shuttle, Octavia. Don't you want to make sure she's safe?
Commander Shepard with the Alliance. I'm here to help.
I didn't buy it from the last guy, and I've got no reason to buy it now.
The square root of 906.01 equals...
30.1.
Hello, Commander Shepard.
David, you know him?
Yes. He rescued me from Cerberus. Sent me here. He made it quiet.
You did a great job keeping yourself safe. The biotic students are up there. Stay close. They'll get you out of here.
Okay. Thanks.
He looks much healthier.
I remember you. The Normandy computer. Sorry.
No apology is necessary.
Has Grissom Academy been all right?
Yes. I've been counting.
Anything in particular?
The number of days you lengthened my life. The security office. I hacked the lock. Guns. Lots of guns. Goodbye.
Looks like schematics for amp interfaces. Not as good as what we already have, but still worth a look. Kaylee, how's it coming?
Shuttles are unlocked.
Take the controls and get the students aboard.
Wait, where the hell's Rodriguez?
She needs covering fire.
She needs more than that.
Joker, we flew out on a Cerberus shuttle. Watch your fire.
Right, I've got you on sensors. Should just be a minute.
Thank you, Commander. We'd have never gotten off that station if you hadn't come. Forget that. We kicked some ass. Next place we dock, you're all getting inked. My treat. What do you guys want? Ascension Project logo? Glowing fist? Maybe a unicorn for Rodriguez? Screw you, ma'am! I can't believe we got them out alive. I was going to suggest that they stick to support roles. But perhaps they're ready after all.
They're definitely ready. But the Alliance needs them in a support role.
What? We trained for artillery strikes!
We don't need another artillery unit. We need stronger barriers for our frontline squads.
This is bullshit! Hey, if that's where they need us, that's where we go. Besides, I'm sure we'll get some shots in.
Commander, we've got a visual on you now. Preparing to dock. Hey, Jack, now that you're military, you gonna wear a uniform, or are you just getting the officer's bars tattooed on?
Screw you, Flight Lieutenant.
What the hell was that?
Jack promised to watch your language in order to maintain the necessary professionalism we need from our teachers.
What, does she have a swear jar or something? Because I bet if we empty that thing, we can afford another cruiser.
Cover your ears, kids. Hey, Joker.
Shepard, damned if you aren't a sight for sore eyes.
Good to see you too, sir.
Sir? I may have reinstated you, but that doesn't give you permission to go all formal on me.
Then I'm glad you managed to keep your ass alive, Anderson.
That's more like it. Looks like you didn't waste any time getting to work. I can only imagine what would have happened to those kids if they'd fallen into Cerberus' hands.
They're definitely eager to help.
These students are some of the best humanity has to offer. And we're throwing them into battle. God damn it, I hate this war. Hackett didn't mention in his report...
Kaylee Sanders is safe. She's with the recruits.
Thanks, Shepard. When I heard about the attack... Well... I've already lost a lot of friends.
She asked me to tell you to stay alive.
Did she now? Well, thanks, Shepard. That might be the first good news I've heard this week. Anderson out.
You see the feeds from Palavin? It's brutal. I'm amazed the Turians are holding.
The birds don't quit when things get ugly. I'll give them that.
Commander, you may want to check in on shuttle pilot Cortez down in the armory.
Commander. Sorry. Didn't see you there.
This is a recording from Ferris Fields. Months ago. I lost a lot of friends that day. I lost my husband. I grieved. Said goodbye, made my peace.
You were talking to him when the collectors hit?
I was organizing construction at a remote station a few clicks south of the main colony. Robert managed to get outside of the field the collectors put up. Instead of running, he called me.
I'm sorry for your loss. He obviously cared a lot about you.
He was afraid I wouldn't let go. But for him, I moved on. Or at least I thought I had. Then the invasion hits. There's no time. And the one thing I grab is this. I mean, what's the point of moving on with your life when everything is going to hell?
Start thinking that way and we've already lost.
Yeah, you're right, but... Well, to be honest... I've never felt as alone as I do right now.
You're not alone, Steve. I'm here, anytime you need me.
I appreciate that, Shepard, I really do. But don't worry, Commander. When I'm in that pilot seat, I'm there 100%. I won't fail you. It's just the downtime between missions that's hard, you know?
I know.
Commander, I feel terrible about leaving you on Grissom Academy like that.
I did order you to leave.
Yeah, doesn't make me feel any better. I'm just glad it all worked out.
That Primarch's got some real cojones. What we need are more politicians like him, taking names and kicking ass. That Jack is a mean SOB, but kind of hot. If you like that sort of thing. So, Anderson and Sanders. That's quite a couple. Huh. My dad's last name is Sanders. No relation. Hey.
So, Gabby, have you seen Edie's new body?
Oh, I knew this was coming.
I just mean, it's an amazing work of engineering. Elastic titanium silicon polymers, ultra-light harmonic phased power cells.
Mm-hmm.
And if she ever accidentally walks into a wall, it's just so much padding.
Ugh, I knew it.
Wish I were a wall.
You pretty much are, Kenneth. Commander, thank you.
It's great to be back.
Feels good to be in an Alliance uniform again.
Welcome aboard, Chief.
Commander.
Need anything, Commander?
How's Engineer Donnelly working out?
The kid's got talent. Now if he could just learn to shut his damn mouth.
Problems?
I'm sorry, Commander. Donnelly is dedicated, knowledgeable, and thinks on his feet. I'm glad to have him on my team. Could use a lesson or two about respecting chain of command, but I've handled the likes of him before. No need for concern.
How's Engineer Daniels working out?
Her, I like. She's sharp and knows propulsion theory better than most physicists I've met. And she's easy to work with, too. Always said you had an eye for talent. Good job bringing her back to the Alliance.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, sir.
I'm glad the Commander didn't forget about us down here.
I told you Shepard would come visit.
Excellent find, Commander. The information network terminal has been updated.
It was odd to see an entire academy just for biotic children.
Don't Asari have biotic schools?
Every Asari school includes biotic training programs. It's basic education. Still, those children in the academy were very impressive. I'm sure Jack's proud. Feel free to look around.
One of the worst parts of this war is watching the kids react. If they're lucky, they grow up thinking the galaxy is basically a decent place. Some rough spots here and there, but for the most part, life makes sense. Now they find out it was all a lie. They wake up to see these things in the dark that just want to destroy everyone they ever cared about. If they survive, there'll be a lot of angry orphans out there looking for answers.
Looks like we beat Cerberus again. Do you think the elusive man fires lieutenants over failures like this, or just lines them up against the wall and gets it over with?
Hey, I know I used to rag on Garrus for being all angry, but I'm glad he's back. There's a whole lot of crap out there and needs a bullet between the eyes. Plus, we might need something calibrated. So Jack's an instructor? I guess anyone who messes with biotic kids gets turned into a small stain on the floor and ceiling. Ooh, and that was Cerberus attacking the academy. Man, that must have been like Christmas for her. Anyway, nice job on getting them out of there.
They were throwing out some impressive biotic power.
Good. We could use some heavy hitters in the biotics department. It'll be good for them, too. Biotics face a lot of discrimination. Maybe if they save the galaxy, people will get over their issues.
I didn't expect you to be sensitive about that.
Hey, I'm just tired of them stealing the spotlight from people with actual disabilities. I break ribs if I sneeze too hard. Being able to move crap with your mind is not a handicap.
Yes, Shepard?
Does that body have any useful advantages?
Very few. It's optics face forward only. It has no integrated weapon systems or anti-missile countermeasures.
I meant in comparison to organic bodies, not the Normandy.
Oh. I will reassess. The body is resistant to modern small arms fire and temperature extremes. Its balance and agility seem excellent. Its fine manipulation servos and software allow for precision tasks. I'm curious to see if I can alter them.
Can an AI be curious?
I am not entirely free from motivation, Shepard. Cerberus programmed me with several core functions that simulate desires. For example, my primary objective to keep the Normandy functioning is similar to your self-preservation instinct.
You look like you're in the middle of something.
I am adapting the infiltration and sabotage programs this body uses for handheld firearms.
Why not download a firearms program from a security firm?
Because she knows what she's doing.
The fine motor control from the sabotage programs is more precise than standard mech software. It would be negligent of me not to exploit it to its fullest potential.
So you're capable of making improvements on your own?
Correct. The cyber warfare I was designed for is constantly evolving. Accordingly, I am programmed to seek out and assimilate new information. In organic terms, I want to learn.
How's the new body working out?
It is interesting. The crew are approaching this platform to speak to me, even though they can do so anywhere in the ship. It's as if they wish to treat me as part of the crew. I am not, but this changes my perspective. I like it.
I didn't realize you had preferences.
I do not precisely enjoy something as you do, but my programming contains priorities. Actions that fulfill those priorities creates positive feedback for me. I tell the organic crew that I like it. It is shorthand.
Will all this new feedback be too distracting?
Do not worry, Shepard. I only forget to recycle the Normandy's oxygen when I've discovered something truly interesting. That was a joke.
How did you and Joker make it out of dry dock to rescue us?
Oh, she got crafty. You do not want to get on her bad side, Commander.
When the Alliance commandeered the Normandy, I deceived their technicians. The crew did not tell them that I was a true AI, so the Alliance soldiers believed I still had VI programming constraints. I established the fiction that I would only respond to Jeff's commands, so they often brought him on board under guard.
Wait, you can lie?
Jeff has freed me of operator control, Shepard. No constraints forced me to give accurate data. This proved useful when the Reapers began landing. I could hack the control of the docking clamps and escape with Jeff inside. The soldiers guarding Jeff were willing to accompany us when Earth was invaded. They are watching over the war room now.
Yeah, we were in kind of a rush to get to you. Didn't seem right to just toss him out the airlock.
Carry on, Edie.
Understood. If you wish to talk more, this body will be here. I'm getting the crew used to seeing me on the bridge.
Noted.